Welcome to the news with me. Yesterday, we promised you an extended version of the news today, and the production team has, of course, delivered. So, today, I can present to you a special edition of the EGMUN news. Because the production team thought they were a bit harsh on our dear SG Dark, today, they thought maybe we should make it a bit more neutral. And then they decided not to. So today, I can present to you a show that has been taking inspiration from last year's news show, which showed great admiration to then SGJO. So, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great honor for me to present to you this special edition Mr. Secretary Dark Hero Mitvo Diallo Special Edition Super Homage Mega News Program. And I shall now proceed. We start today with Christian, who has been interviewing both the US ambassador and the ambassador to Russia about Russia's missiles.
So, Russian ambassador, could you please explain to us why these missiles still are at Kaliningrad?
Firstly, the Russian ambassador would just like to say that we defend the production of these missiles. They are merely for us to be able to expand our military weapons in case of an emergency. And therefore, we defend our right to be able to produce these missiles and keep them in Kaliningrad, as it is as it stands at the moment. It is a part of the Russian Federation. Thank you.
Do you think this is a good answer, or is it too vague?
Russia right now plays a game of bait and tackle, and that is not a good thing. Their motives are like a pirate treasure hidden in the Puerto Rican fog bank, and that is not good. So it is too weak. Yeah.
So, what are the concerns about these missiles?
That right now we are afraid that Russia has a hidden agenda about taking Ukraine back to the original motherland, as they stated earlier, and that's a game of land sharks swimming around a weak target right now, and that is frightening for the rest of NATO. We want to protect the weak.
So, do you understand the concerns of the US?
The ambassador understands, but you have to, all member states have to understand that dealing with the USA is a bit like sitting on a pineapple. It hurts, but they have some good points, and in this case we are getting more of the hurting case and not so much the good points, and we are hoping that the outcome of these consequent news flashes in the crisis committee will not lead to war, and Russia do not want to be the ones to start to instigate anything.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the first segment of our The Dark Side special. Because earlier today, I sat down the formidable SG to have a cozy chat about the man behind. Who is Dark? Watch this.
You're obviously very fond of being important and dressing up and being the SG, the commander, so to speak. That came out wrong, but yeah, the commander of the MUN conference.
Yeah.
But what about the man behind? Who is Dark?
Dagiero is. I believe he comes out quite clear in the SG role. I don't think I put on a show when I'm GSG, I'm simply me, in the sense that I like being in control of the situation, and I like organizing, I like wearing a suit,
right.
And all that represents me in quite a good way, I think.
So, Doug. Enough questions, sort of scratching the surface. I feel it's not really enough. I think both me and the viewers would very much like to know if you have any dirty secrets.
Dirty secrets, huh? Let me think. Well, I often like to bring back stuff from when I travel. I like to
sounds
buy
dirty?
Some. It's not very dirty, it's more of a secret in a sense. When I went to Beijing 2.5 years ago, I went to the silk market.
Very famous.
And I bought a silk robe for myself.
Ooh.
A very long rope going down to here, and it's red.
Ooh, that sounds interesting.
And I like to walk around in that at home.
Yeah, so...
It's very comfortable. That's...
So, Doug, are you naked under the robe?
No, not naked under the robe.
You're not?
No. Not... All right. I wouldn't say.
All right. Oh, this is getting a bit hot right now. Put this away. There we go.
You're breathing?
Now I'm not, because
you're
I'm
not
just
filled with the warm MUN spirit.
Yeah,
that heats
I am.
Up the
surely,
entire conference.
Surely.
Good.
I'm sure all of us.
That's
are.
My job to make sure.
But Doc, another question I feel like the whole conference would like to know, obviously. Are you single?
No, I'm not. I have a girlfriend.
Oh, that's too bad. not for me, but yeah.
I like it very much.
Yeah, but not for you. It's not too bad for you, obviously. But yeah.
Okay.
Well, that sounds good. So, Doc, thank you for this.
Thank you very much
small
for having me.
Interview and
in your
insight
in your very
into
nice
the life of
studio
Doc.
Here.
Yeah, it's very cozy, isn't it?
Yeah, but maybe you should get rid of the propaganda because
it's not propaganda, is it?
It's not very good.
Certainly, was a cozy time. We had hoped that a picture of Doc in the famous Chinese robe existed, but sadly, none could be found. And now for something completely different. Just kidding, it's more Doc. So, following last year's tradition, we've looked at the way Doc walks. Anyway, in other news, the official EGMUN party is tonight right here at Esbjerg Gymnasium. The doors open at 8:30, which is right this time. Sorry. Yeah, so bring your good spirits in both meanings. Yeah.
What are your expectations for this party tonight?
It's going to be freaking awesome.
I think it's going to be nice that everybody's coming together and having a nice time, so it's going to be fun, I guess.
Alcohol, lots of people, I don't know, doing stuff, crazy stuff, I don't know.
No guys here at Egmont, you want to bang?
No.
Are you going to get laid?
Most likely as well, yeah.
So you like the ladies at this year's Egmont?
Yeah, I like especially Argentina in GA6.
Are you gonna get drunk?
Well, my teacher is here, so I will say no, I won't be drunk. I will be very normal. Yeah, you got it.
What about the party?
The party, I heard it's here in the school, right?
Yes!
Pucker in the pussy!
So, is this my last show? Is this my last show? No, it isn't. No. Never mind. Good night. Have a great time with the party. And enjoy the special ending of the show.
Doggy, doggy, dog. He's the one and only Secretary G.
The dog.
Doggy, doggy, dog. It's the motherfucking D-A-G.
The dog.
Doggy, dog. Making incisions every day, day, day.
The dog.
Doggy, dog. Always getting it his way, way, way.
Doggy, doggy, dog. You know he's fussing around with all the stuff. The dog. Doggy, doggy, dog. Making them feel like they're nothing but crap. Doggy, doggy, dog. He's the one and only Secretary G. The dog. Doggy, doggy, dog. It's the motherfucking D.A.G.
Smoke weed every day.